We continue our study with chapter 6, which is machine. So for this chapter is almost all of it are theory. If you don't like theory, you have to memorize it because this almost cover 15% of your final, or around 7.5% of your total mark. So try to memorize it. So there will be four parts for this slide. The first part is the basic construction and principle of a machine. Next is a DC machine. Next is the synchronized machine. And lastly, the induction machine. So what is electrical machine? Electrical machine is actually the transfer of energy, okay, converter that change the electrical input to mechanical output, or vice versa, means that mechanical input and electrical output. So this process is known as electromechanical energy conversion. So you have to know the difference between a motor and a generator. Motor basically just the input is electrical and the output is mechanical. And for generator is the input is mechanical and the output is electrical. As mentioned before, there are three types of machine: DC machine, synchronous machine, and induction machine. So DC machine, of course, produce a DC current, direct current. But for synchronous machine and induction machine, it's produce AC. So you have to differentiate between DC machine and AC machine. There are two phenomena that can makes the electrical machine works. The first one is when a conductor moves in electrical field, a voltage is induced in the conductor. This one is used, this phenomena is used to produce a generator. Means that movement will change to a voltage source or current. And another phenomena is the current carrying conductor is placed in the magnetic field. A conductor experience a magnetic force. Okay, this one is used for motor. Okay, when a current is carrying current, okay, when a conductor is carrying current and it is in magnetic field, it will produce a force. So this is a basic construction of a machine, okay, electrical machine, which is stator and rotor. A rotor is the a stator is a frame of the machine at the outer part, and the rotor is the moving part in the middle of the machine. So this is an example of a DC machine, okay. And this one is an induction machine, and this one is synchronous machine. If you look from three figure here, there is not too much different between this machine, but actually inside it's quite different.